Hello, Bangalooreans. This is our second meeting of online CTAC meeting, that is Citizen Advisory Traffic meeting. The second time we are doing it, second edition of it. And this time we have got more than 60 queries from various people of Bangalore City. Most of them pertain mainly to certain improvements in the road conditions, shifting of bus stops, and many other related aspects in traffic management. I will just go through and try to answer some of them, and others could also be covered. One question from Mr. Sindhura Datta is regarding parking fee system. Many times the person taking care of it does not give the fee slip unless asked for it. Not sure if the slip they give is an authorized one. Is parking fee mandatory? I'm not sure which parking system you are talking about in this regard, because in Bangalore City, on-street parking is not to be paid. There is no fee for on-street parking. That is the parking where it is allowed on the roads itself, except two places, that is Brigade Road and Commercial Street. These two places, there is automated timestamp parking system. You will pay as per by the hour, and it's purely an automated system. Apart from these two streets, in other places there is no parking fee to be levied or collected by anybody. If anybody collects this type of parking fee for on-street parking, you can directly complain to the traffic police control, that is 103, or to our city control room number 100. We will take action on such unauthorized persons trying to collect parking fee for on-street parking, which is supposed to be free. However, if you are talking about off-street parking, that is several multi-level parking lots are there in the city. Many of these malls and other places also there is traffic parking facility available, including multiplexes and all. Here it is the individual building owners who collect this parking fee. So here, if there is any violation, you can either bring it to the notice of the concerned authorities there, or to the BBMP, who is giving licenses to such collection of fees by these authorities. So as such, traffic police has no role in collection of parking fee. But if there is any unauthorized collection, we can step in and take action on such persons for the violation. Prakash asked whether cheetah vehicles are authorized to collect traffic fine. No, cheetah vehicles cannot collect the traffic fine. As per the Indian Motor Vehicle Act and as per the notifications of the government, officers of and above the rank of ASI can only impose and collect traffic fines. Officers of the rank of constables and head constables cannot collect or impose any fine. Cheetah vehicles are generally having either a constable or a head constable, therefore they cannot either collect or impose any traffic fine. However, they can stop the vehicles for general checking based on some input, crime input. They can verify the vehicle documents. They can also inspect the vehicle and find out if the belongings of the vehicle also can be checked by any civilian police officer or traffic police officer. Generally in Bangalore City, the civil police, that is the land order police, who wear the khaki uniform, they do not do the enforcement activity, that is traffic related enforcement activity. It's only the traffic police which does it. However, they are authorized to check the vehicles, and if need be, they can also collect the fines off and above the rank of ASI. But in Bangalore City, most of the enforcement activity is done by the traffic police. Bhuvana Subramaniam brings to our notice the Begur main road, Bhumanali Junction to Hongasandra. There is no proper walkway, and this type of problems many others have also expressed. Bangalore City is facing a lot of this constraint regarding the proper pavements and proper, in fact, in the walkability index also Bangalore fares very poorly. It's very unfortunate. We have to improve our pavements and make our roads more and more pedestrian friendly. we are in dialogue with the BBMP to in this regard, and in their new tender show project, they are creating or executing new type of pavements which are of, which will be of world standard, and I hope in the coming days this situation will improve and there will be proper walkways as well as proper crossing in the main roads. And already BBMP is doing the work of the skywalks at many places. It will also in a way ease the difficulties and problems of the pedestrians in the city. Shatadru Chattopadhyaya brings to the notice that night auto rickshaws, there should be more number of auto rickshaws. He says licenses for auto rickshaws. I think what is meant is that there should be more auto rickshaws in the night times when people try to commit in the night times at higher rates. There are many people refuse to come to the destination sought by the passenger or customer, and for this it is also suggested to conduct auto raid in the night also. We will definitely take action in this regard and try to do some random and surprise checks in the night times whether auto rickshaw drivers ply their auto rickshaws to the destination and as per the meter, and they do not charge exorbitant. Shajesh K. Nair tells that Indranagar signal in front of BMTC bus depot, there is a lot of bottleneck there, and it gives a lot of problems to pedestrians also to cross the roads. We will examine this one, and the local officers will take action on this. Kapil Khatar asked the question, why is every bus stop in Bangalore right in the intersection? A lot of bottlenecks will ease out if these bus stops are pushed a little bit front. Yes, he is very correct. Many of the bus stops in Bangalore City are wrongly placed. Unfortunately, when the city was still growing, when the traffic was not this much, when the signals were not this choked, these bus stops have been existing there. And now, since the number of vehicles on the roads has increased and many of these places have become signalized intersections, it causes a lot of bottleneck for the ongoing traffic. We have already written to the BMTC and BBMP regarding such bus stops in Bangalore City. More than about 150 such bus stops have been identified by us, which cause hindrance to smooth movement of traffic. And we have requested these authorities to shift these bus stands to an appropriate location, either ahead of the signal junction or much before the signal junction, so that they do not cause any hindrance. Already BBMP is on the job, and they are in the process of shifting some of the bus stops which we have indicated. I hope in the coming days this problem gets solved. Kapil Khatar brings to our notice the Kundali junction, the road condition is very bad, and last 3 years there is a lot of potholes and other things. Yes, this problem we have also observed, and we are in dialogue with the BBMP to improve the road conditions here and to fill the potholes. In the coming days, definitely this will be addressed too. Kapil Khatar again brings to our notice Bellandur flyover between 5 pm and 8 pm in the evening. There is total mess there and a lot of problems. We will look into it and try to address this one. Venkat Subramanian brings to our notice that he stays in Palace Kutrali Main Road, which is parallel to near to the Malleshwaram and cantonment of Maker Circle. There he finds it difficult to, there is no proper footpath because of which he finds it difficult to walk in that road. Yes, this will be looked into, and we will take action on this also. Subin Thampi says that he has been wrongly penalized at a place he has never gone, and the respective police inspector has not addressed to his issue, and he says that whether he can visit the automation center and resolve this issue. Yes, definitely you can visit our automation center, and our officers will be happy to resolve whatever issue you have got with regard to your violation notice which you have received. Manjunath Modur Prasanna says, even though the flyovers has eased traffic, say, from Silkwood Junction to Martharli, the BTM to Silkwood Junction is too bad during peak hours. Earlier this year, the CM had announced a flyover till Silkwood Junction. Will this help? What are the other plans of by BTP? Also, buses still stop on the main road instead of Silkwood. Can BTP move all of them to service road? Yes, it's an important, many important issues have been raised by Manjunath, and Yes, there is a proposal for an elevated corridor there from Chaideva Hospital Junction to Silk Board. Both metro and the elevated flyover are supposed to come there, but it's a long-term project. It will take some time for it to materialize. As of now, we have done some traffic management measures in this stretch to ease the congestion. Every day there is a lot of traffic pileup here, especially during the peak hours. We have noticed it, and this stoppage of buses near Silk Board, that also causes a lot of confusion and chaos. We are already in the process of shifting some of these bus stops to a proper location there. The work has already been executed by BD and BBM. Hopefully, a few of these bus stops will be shifted shortly. Tirumala Rao Ranganath brings to our notice about the Graphite India signal. It takes 1 hour on Friday evening. Yes, Graphite India signal, which connects the Whitefield area to the city, it gets choked during peak hours, and especially during Fridays. The problem is very acute, mainly because many of these corporate employees, they bring their own vehicles on the weekend, so that they can have their own mode of transport for the evening, because they will be having the weekend parties and other things. So Friday evening the problem is very, very acute in this area. We have to find out some solution for this congestion. We are already in the process of it, and we have made a lot of spot visits to this area, and we are also in dialogue with the civic agencies for this. Ranjan Jain suggests that the stretch starting from Old Madras Road going through Nagavarapalle and connecting to Bagh Bazar, this can be made into a one-way. We will definitely examine this one and try to resolve it. Rakshit Pramod asks whether the number plates can be written in Kannada. No, the number plates cannot be written in Kannada. The number plates, as per the Indian Motor Vehicle Act, should be written in English, and there is a specific size, font and format for this to do so. However, Kannada number plates can also be put in addition to the English number plates, only Kannada number plates cannot be there on the vehicles. Deepak Mishra brings to the notice that near Vignan Nagar bus stop there is a lot of peak hour traffic jams are there, and there is a T junction which also causes a lot of problems. We will look into it and try to resolve the problem. Ramchandra Shanai brings to our notice that the hooters which are put up at the signal lights for the pedestrian signal, they cause more of sound pollution because their sound level is very high. Yes, we have noticed this problem in some of the intersections, some of the junctions. The sound decibel level is a bit higher. So we have already asked our vendor to rectify these signal lights, and if you have got any specific intersections where the sound level is higher, if you write to us, we will get it verified, and we will try to reduce the sound level in these junctions. Santosh Bora indicates that the number plates are not as per the provisions of the Indian Motor Vehicle Act. He wants to enforce this rule. Yes, we are doing it, and we will definitely intensify the drives on these things. Christopher Stanley indicates that JP Nagar second phase, there are a lot of taxis and other vehicles parked under the underpass. This is a specific issue. We will look into it. Ramakrishnan asks about measures taken by the Bangalore Traffic Police regarding curbing of illegal drag racing, especially on Nice Road. Wherever we get information or wherever such drag racing or wheeling comes to our notice, we have been taking action, and we have been taking very stringent action. We are registering the FIR on such offenders and seizing their vehicles, and also writing to the transport department for suspension of the driving license as well as cancellation of the RC of the vehicle which is involved in such drag racing or wheeling. Gopinath Kini indicates that small improvements will go a long way to improve traffic system, and he has given many suggestions which are very varied and very logical and common sense suggestions he has given. We will pass on these suggestions to our local officers. I hope they will act on these things. Ravi Kiran again indicates the traffic on outer ring road, the many problems faced on the outer ring road by the commuters. Yes, outer ring road is one important stretch, and there are a lot of bottlenecks and hindrances in this outer ring road. We have already done some study with regard to the outer ring road traffic management, and we are shortly having the dialogue with the BDA authorities to try to improve the conditions on the outer ring road. Andy Ram indicates that whenever there is rain, there is a lot of traffic jam. Yes, it is often observed in Bangalore City. Whenever it rains, the main reasons for such traffic jam is that whenever it rains, there are many places water gets locked because of this water lagging. The vehicles will, there will be slow moving vehicles. The vehicles cannot move freely, so because of which it causes a lot of traffic congestion. And second thing is, at many of the places, the two wheelers will stop their vehicle. They cannot ply in the rain, so that also causes congestion. So the waterlogging points we have already identified, and we have requested the BMP authorities to clear these places of waterlogging, which will ease out the traffic during the rainy season. Raghavendra Swami indicates that Ullala Circle needs a traffic signal. Yes, we will examine it, and then we will take it up in the under our BTAC project. If it is feasible and required there for a traffic signal junction, we will definitely erect one in the coming days. So these are some of the questions. Many repetitions are there. I have omitted some of the questions because of that one. Otherwise, this covers the entire set of questions or queries raised by the people regarding this month's CTAC meeting. Regarding last month's queries, whatever you had raised, we had circulated these your comments and suggestions to the field officers. They have given detailed reports on this one, and they have already taken action on certain issues which are in their hands to do so, and other things we will be attending to it depending on what needs to be done there and which agency has to do the works. We will be writing to the concerned authorities to take up the works. So thank you very much, and keep sharing your views, suggestions to us. We will look forward to it, and it will help us, enable us to provide better delivery of service to the people. Thank you, and have a